You're tuning into the TechMe Show.
Today I'm going to teach you something, well, straight from my blog. I've tried for a while now to get people's attention to this. It's an issue in Windows 8 here, and basically it allows everyday people with the brain power and the will and skill to get into our apps that we create and basically see the source code to it, for the most part. At least not very well for C++ apps, but C# and HTML5 apps, and which you'd obviously expect any HTML app, you'd be able to see the source, whether it was on the web or, you know, a Metro app. But nonetheless, this should not be able to be done. So we're gonna real quick do it for those who may not have visited my site. So which you can visit at lance.compulsivetech.biz. So let's not waste any time. Let's go forth and go to my computer, or computer rather, go into your local disk wherever the Windows installation is. And we want to go to the regular program files, which is the 64-bit. How do we know? Because one says x86, which is 32-bit, and the one without is the 64. So we double-click that. As you see, it says Windows Apps. Now, Lance, mine doesn't say that. Well, that's for a good reason. I have hidden items visible. Normally, you would see this. So if you were somebody else other than me, you'd have that off. But now if you're me, you of course have everything hidden visible, only because even operating system files most of the time, simply because I want to make sure nobody's infecting me, somehow something got through. There's always the chance, no matter what kind of protection you have, there's always a way for someone to mess with you, and they like to hide the files. So this way I have the one up, which I recommend you guys do too. So, now you're going to see the Windows Apps folder. You're not going to be able to get into that. You do not have this privilege. So instead of going through all the pop-ups, let's just do it the hack-away way. So we're going to right-click where it says Windows Apps. We're going to left-click Properties. And now we want to select Security. And we want to select, well, we could go to Advanced, right? And see where it says Owner. We want to go ahead and change that. I put it to administrator for the video, but otherwise it's usually trusted installer, because I've been working on some other hacks to do with the system, and it doesn't matter. But maybe I'll make videos on those too. So we're going to go down to our normal user account. For me, it's going to be Lance right here, which is also tied into my live account. Well, it was my live account until somebody started requesting passwords for that account, so I thought to be safe I'd make another account. So now I don't mind using this account and having everybody see it. I really don't use it now, but more than welcome to keep requesting passwords. But anyways, we'll go ahead and select OK. So now we have this account, which is my tied in account to the computer, so I could use my regular username, or in this case my live, which I recommend you using your live anyways, so you can have the cloud and everything pretty much synced. Anyways, so we want to select replace owner on SIP containers and objects, right? Go ahead and select apply, give that a moment. Okay, just simply press OK. Now we're going to go down to my account right here. Like I said, we have multiple accounts, but we're going to want to go ahead and select where it says read, view, and show advanced permissions. As you see, I don't have full control, right? Now let's go to this one. Again, no full control. We need full control, right? So we can go to effective access, select the user. Now I could just type it like most people would, but I like to go in and manually do it like this. Press OK. And again, I'd like to view the effective access again. So we're triple sure that I do not have complete access, right? Click OK. Now we're back to the WinApps properties. We make sure we're on our name. As you see, we still don't have full control, right? So we're going to left-click Edit, and we're going to go down to our name, and see, now we can do full control Allow. Select apply. Give it a moment. Do not cancel. And we want to make sure we have full control because we want access to view files and what have you. But I do not recommend you actually save anything you change in these apps. Simply because somehow Microsoft goes on and checks the authenticity of it and can detect, oh, you changed the title? Sorry, it's not going to work. Or that may be just something in the compiler or whatever it is for Windows 8. But nonetheless, anyways, as you see, we have full control. Let's go to advanced. Let's go back to our name. Now, you notice we don't have two accounts anymore here. But we'll click view. Show advanced permissions. We have everything, people. We have everything. So we'll click close. Click OK. We're going to click OK again. Now, here comes the fun part. Double click. Woo! Now we have access to everything here. That's not good. Mommy! Oh, Mommy didn't save us from this one, did she? So, let's go into iCookbook. Great app, by the way. Here's their JSON file. Let's go see it. Hey, we can make our own JSON app. And there you go. Number and bunch of digits, and looks like there's some security keys in here. Which, okay. Whatever. I mean, maybe not, but just the way I'm looking at it. So here's the default HTML file to the iCookbook. We'll right-click it, and we'll just simply click Edit. Now, that's only because I already have HTML going to Notepad or WordPad rather than opening in Internet Explorer, which in that case, it would not work properly. So we're going to click Open With, and then most likely you're going to get this type of screen. Use this app for all .html files? No, which would only be Internet Explorer. Left-click See All, and then you would slide in. Oh, where is my Notepad? Oh, look, Notepad. Again, it wouldn't say keep using. So we left-click Keep Using Notepad. And voila. Now you have the main part to, well, cookbook is what they're calling it. Here's the JavaScript references right here. You can tell by the JS, hence JavaScript. Here's the references for the CSS, which is the cascading style sheets, which is how it basically displays. If you don't have CSS nowadays, most sites look like junk. And again, more JavaScript it's trying to load. Different things, obviously, it's trying to do queries, join, select, etc. And what have you. File, in and out, whatever. Timer, and what have you. Navigator, and great. Problem is, guys, we should not be able to see the source codes to this. We could go into CSS, which, again, like I've always said, you know, you can't get around HTML slash HTML5 apps. There's just no way. But the fact is, what if I was storing a source file here with my username and password because I'm a premium member, let's say. Now a bug or something could come through, or somebody who has the mind power to basically come in and, well, unfortunately, get my username and password, or some kind of worm going to get my Twitter name, my Facebook, my LinkedIn, or whatever, and send it back to them, and they can set up a bot to start sending spam under my account, which would suck. And eventually people would stop following me, not that I have many, but you know, it would piss off the people that are there. But see, here's the tile icon, which we could change right here if I didn't want it to be look like that. I could say, hey, to some lady, assuming one would come back with me, hey, look at my app. Make her think I'm some smart rich guy. Yeah, wouldn't that be nice? Anyway, so we here's Solitaire. Everybody loves Solitaire, right? This looks like it's made probably in C++. It looks like quite a bit. And the reason I claim this is because there's a lot of DLLs, which, again, means absolutely nothing. Absolutely nothing. Which we could, you know, probably find out really what it was made in, and what have you. But, yeah, I mean, here you have the identity to the app and what have you. And it's a great app, don't get me wrong. I like Solitaire like the next guy. But I don't like the fact that source codes could be visible to pretty much anybody. And certain ways I connect my app to my servers or keys and what have you. I mean, you just have to go totally out of your way to start encrypting your programs, assuming you can figure a way to do that. Yes, there's third-party tools like from Preemptive and what have you, but, you know, it's a pain in the butt. It should just be done. But, yeah, so I can recommend just using Visual C++ to maybe make apps, but I will continue with C#. I don't mind, you know, people seeing my source code, but I mind if they take away the ads, if it's a free app, if they pay for the app, which I don't really do that too much anymore, make people pay for it. But, you know, keep our ads in there, people. This is how we make things so you can steal them. But anyways, as you see, we're learning here how American Airlines made their app. We can technically copy all this and make our own app and call it our own and steal somebody's source code. But let's just hope Microsoft does something about this. But please don't get mad at them. There's always issues. This is a public release. I've kept my mouth shut for about 2 months now trying to get somebody from their team to get back to me. And nobody's gotten back to me, so I thought I would publicly release my findings, and now beyond my blog post, people didn't understand it, and as much as I really don't want them to understand it, I thought we'd make this for the TechMe Show. So, here you guys go, hope you like it, and thank you for tuning in, and we'll see you next time, guys.